So season 2 ended with this massive cliffhanger. We're assuming everybody's still alive. How quickly will we start seeing everybody in the first episode? Or are we going to have some gaps where somebody's missing in that episode?
Somebody might be missing for a while. Somebody might be. I don't know.
All will be revealed September 21st.
Yeah. But we can't really give that away.
I was pretty surprised when I watched, when I read the first episode. I mean, obviously we knew the ending, but we had no clue. And when I read it, I was very excited about it. You know, it's exciting to see them do something different like that. You know, ending in the whole big fight and all of that is really, really neat. It makes for a very exciting opener.
Yeah, we were pretty, like, infuriated, actually, as fans. We're like, what? You can't end it there.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like 3 a.m., right. You know, for them. So
they send a writer up for each episode, and we sort of descend on them with all our ideas, like good and terrible.
Yeah.
And then hopefully they ignore everything you say and go back and write some good stuff.
We keep pitching the idea where we're constantly like walking up behind Nathan and like trying to play with his ear and poke him, but he doesn't feel it. We just want to get that as like a recurring theme of the show.
Or the musical episode.
And the musical. We've been pitching that for years.
We've been pitching that forever.
We do, and we play it. I mean, yeah, this would be.
We're like a family band.
Yeah.
Like the Partridge
Family. Like an indie folksy band.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've
got to
push
that. But not like a creepy one. Not like a creepy one.
Sometimes in a creepy one.
Which has become much more comfortable than it was initially, but now I've embraced that and it just sort of let it take me where it goes.
What you do is so kind of ridiculous for a living. I mean, when you've sat around enough times and you've read a script, you can go, my character wouldn't say that. I wouldn't do that. And then you stop for a second and you're like, what am I saying? It's there. And you'll argue with the writers. You'll be like, I would never do that. They're like, says who? We're the one who wrote it. And I'm like, well, I just know my character. I know my character wouldn't do that. They're like, but we wrote it. We wrote the character. I'm like, well, so, we all get caught up in our heads. And we make a really big, I do. I make a really big deal out of stuff. And, my character wouldn't, how is he changing like this? Like, it's better than Lane Rufus. Bottom of the end of the day, it's better than Lane Rufus.
It's exciting. I think I struggle with that a lot on the show of not knowing what's coming up. But I always try to use it in terms, because Audrey is just as frustrated that she doesn't know and that nobody's telling her and giving her any answers and that she feels like everybody around her knows. So I just always try to kind of piggyback on that feeling and try to just say, okay, well, if nobody is going to tell me and they're going to keep me in the dark, then I just got to use that to try to make it through the scenes today, because that's an identical feeling. But something that's been really fun this year, and I think consistently, is discovering the different people that Audrey also is. And that's been a challenge, because now I actually have to figure out and put a voice and a face and create this other person, So that's exciting from an acting standpoint, because that opens up a whole different world, and it's really exciting to get to open up an episode and say,
maybe you could generally describe what your character's arc is going to be. I mean, some of the things we discovered the first season was nobody knew exactly what was going on. But the second season, you guys kind of figured out where it's kind of stemming from and how to deal with it. So what's the third season going to be for your character?
Well, that would mean that they've told us the end if we knew the arc, and we don't know that. So we can tell you up to a point, potentially.
Yes. Without giving too much away, I will say I am super hopeful, then very hurt, then very suspicious, rightfully so, flirting with the dark side, realizing the error of my ways.
pursue his dream of becoming a professional dancer.
And he's good.
He's good. I mean, I really took a lot of inspiration from John Travolta and Staying Alive. And that's, it's gonna be great.
Yeah.
We had a little actor on our show who said it best when he said, like, so, Sean, so I'm happy, 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 sad? He was like, yes, yes, happy, 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 sad. Okay, on action, so I'll be happy, 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 sad. Yes, exactly. I'm sad, 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 happy?
Yeah, a little guy.
A kid.
It was with the most, because inevitably you have to change up that dynamic to make that dynamic interesting, to bring them all together. You have to break them apart, and there are times throughout, especially this season, where the groupings of us have been separated for periods of time and have been split apart, and we're all sort of going on our own adventures. And I think one of the things we always miss is, like, God, I miss the season when it's just the three of us, like, hanging out and being these characters. That can be challenging, because we I think there is something to what you're saying. There's a really fun, special dynamic between the three of us on the show. Not so much in real life.
Yeah, we really don't. I mean, like,
don't mind my hand on the table on his leg. Or on hers.
I always leave you out.
Sorry.
She's married. We gotta be respectful.
Yeah. All right, cool.
Yeah, it's different.
And you have a girlfriend.
Yeah. My girlfriend's fantasy to see us make out.
Oh my God, is that gonna come in the
Yes.
I know, the other side of the love triangle, right?
Yes. Yes. The triangle has obsessed.
There we go.
I'm gonna pitch my idea. I'm gonna pitch my idea for the episode. Okay, so there's a trouble, and this trouble happens, and it means that we all have to hide in the Grey Gull. It's the only place that's safe. We have to, like, spend a night there inside the Grey Gull because this thing is, like, passing over Haven. I don't know what it is. I haven't gotten that far. Somebody else will beat that up. So we're stuck in the Grey Gull all night. We can't leave there because we're hiding from this trouble. And we get drunk.
Very.
We start drinking all night long, and then me and Nathan start to argue. And then at one point, we're staring at each other, and we just... And then, wait, can I finish my idea? And then the next morning, we wake up, and Audrey's like, you guys? And we're like, what?
No,
that wasn't like that at all. It was totally...